We need to talk about the 2nd of February in the year 2020. Now, a lot of people have spotted that this is a palindromic date, so it's the same forwards as it is backwards. You know, the second half is kind of the reverse of the first half. And a lot of people have spotted that this works in the UK.
Yes,
and
you can
either have the 2nd of Feb in the UK style, or you can have Feb 2nd in the US style. And I'm very aware there are other calendars out there. This is just for calendars with the year as 2020. And I know it's not just the UK and the US who have their dates around the various ways. Whatever country you're in, just remember which one you're using. And you do need the zeros. I will not accept any dates that don't use all four digits, 2 for the day and 2 for the month. Now, palindromic dates are semi-common, I would say. We're in a bit of a gold mine at the moment. So both types of calendars, the US and the UK, have 366, I'm including the 29th of February, possible day-month combinations. And for each of those, they uniquely define a year. So both calendars have 366 palindromic dates per every 10,000 years, 12 of which are the same day in both calendars, but the rest are different. So if you're in the US, it's been a long time since there was a palindromic date coming out of the previous millennium. So the last one, last millennium, was August 31st in the year 1380, and then a very long wait until finally October the 2nd in 2000, and you're doing it right there, 2001. There are going to be 36 palindromic dates in the US calendar during this millennium. The last one will be September 22nd on the year 2290. And then we've got another very, very long wait until the 3rd of October in the year 3001. Now you can, you've already done the UK dates.
Oh yes.
Clever. Okay, so likewise in the UK, the dates are a little bit different. The last one, last millennium, was the 29th of November, 1192. Wow, that's a wait. 60. So the US style has a more even distribution, whereas the UK style, they tend to clump because the date can be bigger than the month, and where you put that makes a difference to which year it works in, and then so on. So, all right, you get the idea. Now, for the ones that overlap, they are very rare. So the 2nd of Feb 2020, that is only the 4th time it's happened. We've already used up December and November and January. This is the February one, and the next one won't be until the 3rd of March 3030. So that's over 1,000 years of waiting. So that alone means we should be celebrating the 2nd of Feb 2020. However, so if you have a look at the actual day, which is the 2nd of February, it turns out it is the 33rd day in the year. The actual day in the year is also a palindrome. Not only that, because 2020 is a leap year, there are 333 days left in the year. So it's on a palindromic day of the year, and there's a palindromic number of days left in the year. It's a palindromic split in the year.
So
now,
good.
These are incredibly rare. So years either have 365 or 366 days, and you can see you can split them 2, 3, 6, 3, or you know, 33, 3, 3, 3. There's only 4 options. They can go either way. So you could have either the 3rd day in the year and 363 left, or you could have the 363rd day in a leap year and 3 left. Although not all of them work. Half of them get knocked out because the year they have to happen in is either not a leap year when it needs to be, or is a leap year when it shouldn't be. You only end up, once it's all done, with just these 8. And you can see that the UK last had a palindromic date, which was also a palindromic split in the year 1022. The US, well, US people, yours was much more recent in 2020. And now you can have a look, this is it. This is the only one that overlaps. 2020, both styles of writing the date have a palindromic date on the same day, and it's a palindromic split in the year. And for the record, this also works with official ISO date format where it's year, then month, then day. Like it works, it's so good. In fact, yeah, I've got my own bit of paper. Check it out. It's the middle of the, that doesn't work as well when I, can you give that a go? Okay, so it's the middle of the triangle of wonder. Not only is it a palindromic date, not only is it working in both the US and the UK style calendars at the same time, but on top of all of that, it's a palindromic split in the year. That will never happen again. We will get a lot of them in 10,000 years, because if you put the one in front of 2020, it still works, apart from the ISO date. That doesn't work, which is why this is the most palindromic date ever. It's definitely the most palindromic date of this decamillennium, and I would argue it's the most palindromic date we will ever have. You have got to celebrate the 2nd of Feb 2020. I'm very sorry if you're watching this video after that date. Thanks for watching the video. Lastly, we have a little stat for you, if you don't mind. So we'll just look it up now. Yeah, just looking it up now, it is 37.5%. 0.5%. That's the percentage of people who watch my videos and are also subscribed to my Stand Up Maths channel. So just 37.5%. Come on, what's the other 62.5% of you are freeloading? Yes, I know it pops up in your recommended feed and you log in and it's there, but I know. Look, if you're watching the videos and you enjoy them, or even if you're new to the channel, please do subscribe. Both of us would really, really appreciate it. It helps the channel. If you watch the videos or you just want to see more like this, please hit the subscribe and like and do all that other stuff. So there you are. That's my video about palindromes, which I think worked out quite well.
It was pretty good. I was very pleased with that.
Yeah.
Should we have a high five?
Oh yeah, let's. Actually, yeah, let's not. That's, yeah. No, terrible idea. No.